Well, good Thursday afternoon, everybody. As we take a look at the weather here, you do know that the drought has been making headlines over the last week or two. And unfortunately, drought conditions have expanded now across most of eastern Massachusetts, and not a lot of relief in sight. We do have the chance of some weakening showers or thunderstorms moving through tonight and again on Friday or overnight Friday night. But again, nothing major in sight. So we will have to monitor these conditions as we go through the next several weeks. Again, weakening showers moving through overnight tonight, perhaps again on Friday, but no drought busters, that's for sure. A warm and dry weekend, though, is on tap. I say relatively warm because it does look like much hotter air will be building with another heat wave as we go into next week. We'll talk about that in just a moment. 83 degrees outside the BTV studios. It's been a mostly cloudy day. It's actually looked threatening out there. It looks like it wants to rain, but not quite yet. Temperatures generally in the lower 80s across most of the region, a little bit cooler along the beaches, especially the south coast today. And we do have a severe thunderstorm watch in effect for far western New England on into upstate New York. We've been monitoring the radar and the satellite as we've gone through the morning here. Again, some pop-up showers have been trying to start here across southern New England, but most of the action has been far to the north and west, out towards the Great Lakes, moving on into Rochester and Buffalo. And we'll kind of monitor here locally. Again, you can see signs of a few storms trying to pop up right now. As a matter of fact, towards the Rhode Island, Massachusetts border, those will probably go north and west of us. And again, a few weakening showers or storms may try to come through the area later on tonight. Temperature's pretty mild here across most of the country. Again, the heat starting to build off to the south and east and down towards the Gulf Coast, ahead of some weakening fronts that are moving here off to the east. This front will be introducing some nice weather for us, though, as we go into the weekend. So something to look forward to. Here it is tomorrow into Friday, kind of dying as it moves across southern New England. Probably not enough to give us any soaking rains or anything like that, but it will bring the dew point down just a little bit. Now, let's fast forward to next week, because we will have, again, as I mentioned, a building heat wave with our fronts here going again well to the north. The cool air will be back into a central Canada by that time. And we will have high pressure building across the eastern part of the country as it did last week. But the difference this time is that that high pressure, warm high pressure, is going to be coupling with our Bermuda high. And that's going to be kind of a double whammy here, bringing lots of hot weather on up the East Coast and right on up into southern New England. Yesterday, models were giving us some crazy numbers, talking about highs, maybe 110 degrees by next Friday. Not sure it's going to be going that high, but mid to upper 90s and flirting with the century mark is going to be quite possible here as we get to about a week or so from now. So something to kind of keep in the back of your mind. Certainly not for tonight, though, although it will be a muggy night. Temperatures generally around 70 degrees for a low. That's it. With, again, maybe an early shower or storm. Now for tomorrow, it's going to be hot, up near 90 degrees. I think Boston down towards Bridgewater, a little bit cooler along the south coast and the Cape, and also up towards the main beaches. We'll have a few thunderstorms that are going to be approaching off to the west, so that may keep them a little bit cooler as well. So it looks like Boston to Bridgewater to Providence, that'll be the hottest area for your Friday. How about the next several days? Again, some showers and storms weakening form possibly here late Friday night into Saturday morning, but I'll be long gone by the time most of us wake up. And then it's just a warm and dry Saturday and Sunday before the heat and humidity builds once again for early next week.